You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension. A dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
That's what you're doing. It's 5:30 in the morning. Haven't been up this early for weeks. Okay, that's a lot. We did 2 days. 5 days ago, we worked the two nights out on Beaver Dam to the SemCam, doing that tank farm and test equipment. Been grafted in to take over. Shane came back from Mexico and he got first up, and he was out doing the rest of that tank farm that's out on the Bronson that I got the tail end of and set up for the service rig. They got Chinook's floater on. Excuse me. 1.7 or 8 on the Bronson, which is right at the very end. He's pulling the tanks out of there and bringing them to harder ground, I guess. And then I've got a feeling we got T-bed, and we had the green bed truck was at our shop getting a new A-box. If the gear is still sitting on the bench there, I'll show that. And so I'm gonna just jump in the pilot car because the truck's sitting out there at 6 kilometers, already chained up, ready to rip. Well, it's not running, but basically go out there in the pilot car, hop in the bed truck, and just shuttle tanks back and forth to where we set up that service rig, where that Roland's rig was, or is still, probably, maybe, it should be still there. And yeah, that's what we'll be doing today. It might go into 2 days. Let's hope it goes into 2 days. Could use the hours. Help a starving oil field worker by liking, sharing, and subscribing. And, make a donation on Patreon. Maybe I should put the donate button at the bottom of the YouTube screen, but people can barely give a thumbs up, so I don't know how people are going to donate a one-time shot donation through YouTube. I should look into that. Comment below if you'd be interested in donating some money to a starving oil field worker. I know some people do, and a lot of channels have that, so I'm pretty sure it's just a one-time donation. I don't know what the perks are for that. And from what I looked into it, you just get like recognition in the comments. You can buy like super thanks or something. I don't know. It sounded kind of dumb to me, but I know there is giving people out there that like to donate, so we'll check into that. But anyways, yeah, it's been pretty grim. Surprisingly, usually we just get right into doing rail stuff. As soon as road mounts come on, we don't miss a beat. We're doing rail stuff. But for some reason this year, that's not happening at all, so word is that there's still frost in the ground. I'm like, how can there be still frost in the ground? Because we were still kind of signed to do that stuff to go to Winnipeg, but they're like, there's still frost. I'm like, how can there still be frost? There's still frost. Okay, but I did some shit. Painted the bumper. Got ambitious and painted some other stuff. Did all in there, greased. Still got all that to do yet. Which one I was gonna come in and do today, but instead I'm gonna do this, so. right here in Detroit. Parked it right in the mud. Did it get muffled? Nope.
Cool.
First time running this truck, so I'm gonna be a little slow off the first tank, maybe.
Grab that catwalk!
Thank you.
pipeline.
Thank you. The devil went to Jamaica. He was looking to sell some weed. He was doing fine. They were standing in line. It was excellent weed indeed. When he came across this young man who was likewise peddling pot, and the devil slid down the beach to the kid and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I guess you kind of figured I'm a reefer head, of course. And after all this time, I guess that I'm a connoisseur of sorts. Now, your stuff smells okay, but this could tranquilize a horse. I'll bet a million in cash against your stash, because I think mine's better than yours." The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and you ain't smoked nothing yet. One hit of this grass will kick your ass. You got yourself a bed. Johnny, roll a ball of hash and make sure it's the bomb, because the devil's got the kind of stuff they smoked in Vietnam. You'll get a million smackaroos in cash if you can cope, but if you can't, the devil will get your dope." The devil packed a bong with a little Acapulco gold, and resin flew from his fingertips as he fired up his bowl. He filled that chamber all the way, and he took a mighty hit. As they passed it back and forth, it gave them both a coughing fit. Damn. When the bowl was finished, Johnny said, "Hey man, that stuff was great, but fill your lungs with some of this and prepare to vegetate. Cannabis sativa, sweet Mary Jane. The devil's in the backyard frying his brain. Zigzag filled with a diggity dank. Hold on tight, it'll hit you like a tank." The devil nodded off because he knew that he was stoned, and he asked if he could buy an ounce of the stuff that Johnny owned. Johnny said, "Devil, just come on back if you ever want to catch a buzz. I done told you once, you son of a bitch, mine's the best there ever was." And they fired up doobies one by one. Ain't it gonna stop till the bag is done. Green as a bullfrog, sticky as glue. Granny, do you get high? Yes, I do.
Thank you. gotta take me away, like I can't live without you. Today, make it love tomorrow. Sorry, something you're so fragile. Die today, you disgrace the model.
Gives me something to go home and edit.